Welcome, cuties. Let's create. Today, I am going to draw a St. Patrick's Day outfit, and I apologize that I didn't post one last week because I was out of town. So I will be posting two this week, but from now on, it should just be one a week. This is just a very short video. I didn't have a whole lot of time from coming back to getting a video out, but what I did is I was envisioning this kind of like rainbow on top and then kind of thinking of things to do on bottom. And I don't really like how the bottom turned out, but I envisioned kind of this like gradual, you know, with clovers and with little flecks of gold. Because, you know, those are some things that also go with St. Patrick's Day. But they get, you know, it's very full on top, and then it gradually descends to less on bottom. And I wanted to give her curly red hair because, I don't know, that's just something I think of when it's probably really rude and stereotypical, because that's what I think of when I think of, you know, Irish. I think especially the Celtic dances when they have the, you know, the really curly hair and, you know, they're dancing and it's bobbing up and down. Anyway, I don't like how her mouth turned out, but that's okay. You know, I like how the outfit turned out. I think it turned out really cute. I only gave her one hand because, and sorry for my glasses, that they, you know, my head was in the way. But I was really not in the mood to draw two hands because, as you all know, I don't like drawing them because they're really hard and I am just not good at it. And so I was just like, you know what, I'm not in the mood. I'm just going to draw the rest. And she's just going to have one hand and the other hand is going to be missing. You know, maybe I'll go back and I'll draw in, but I just, yeah. But I like the colors. I like the rainbow on top. And I wanted to, you know, have the big belt in the middle because, you know, you think of the leprechauns, they always have the top hats and they have the big belt that goes all the way around. And so I kind of wanted to incorporate that. I was thinking, okay, maybe it will have this grayish blue at the top and then slowly fade to white, but it didn't end up turning out well. It was difficult because the markers that I have are a chisel tip on one side and then a tiny bullet nip on the other side. And where I feel like if I had a brush marker, you know, I'd be able to get that kind of flow. But it turned out fine. And I have really enjoyed coloring with marker and then shading with colored pencil. And so that's what I did in this, and I tried to salvage the bottom half of her dress. But this is how she turned out. I think she turned out really cute. And again, sorry this is late, but here she is. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell for notifications, leave a like and a comment. Until next time, keep creating.